Adobe Illustrator is a great tool, but what are the actual uses of it for graphic design? What is up, people? It's Tom from Satori Graphics back again with another graphic design tips video. Before we start, I'm thanking all of my subscribers for pushing me above that 1,000 mark. Also, if you are subscribed and you want to stay updated to all of my videos, click the bell icon for notifications. YouTube kind of wants us to subscribe twice to our channels these days. Just a quick update on my Wacom giveaway that ended on the 10th of February. The winner was randomly selected, and Jeroen Veeron from the Netherlands was the winner. Congratulations to him, but I'll be doing another giveaway either at 5k subscribers or 10k subscribers, so be sure to watch out for that. What is Adobe Illustrator? Seems to be the first logical question to ask. Adobe Illustrator is a program used by both artists and graphic designers to create vector images. It is often used to draw illustrations, cartoons, diagrams, charts, and logos. Unlike bitmap images that store information in a grid or dots, Illustrator uses mathematical equations to draw shapes. This makes vector graphics scalable without the loss of resolution. So, Adobe Illustrator is an amazing tool for graphic design, there's no doubt about that. And if you followed my channel for any length of time, then you know I have more tutorials and tips based around Illustrator than Photoshop. Why is that, you might ask? Well, there are a myriad of reasons, but today I'm going to show you four reasons why I personally think Adobe Illustrator is essential for graphic design and what kind of uses it will have for you as a designer. I would like to point out, however, that each software has its own place, and as any tool does, it has its own uses just as much as the next one. Bitmap or raster images are stored as a series of tiny dots called pixels. Each pixel is actually a very small square that is assigned a color and then arranged in a pattern to form the image. When you zoom in on bitmap images, you can see the individual pixels that make up each image. Bitmap graphics can be edited by erasing or changing the color of individual pixels using programs such as Adobe Photoshop. Unlike bitmaps, vector images are not based on pixel patterns, but instead use mathematical formulas to draw lines and curves that can be combined to create an image from geometric shapes such as circles and polygons. Vector images are edited by manipulating the lines and curves that they make up using a program such as Adobe Illustrator. Vector images are also more scalable than bitmap. When a bitmap image is scaled up, you begin to see the individual pixels that make up that image. This is most noticeable at the edges of the image. There are ways of making these jagged edges less noticeable, but if this often results in making the image blurry as well, then you want to use Adobe Illustrator. When a vector image is scaled up, the image is redrawn using mathematical formula and equations. The resulting image is just as smooth as the original can be. This is one reason among many why vectors should be used for logo designing, but vectors ensure a crisp, smooth quality outline for all artwork, and can be used to design web-based graphics as well as print-based graphics. However, vector formats are not well supported on the web. The two most popular image formats used on the web are GIF and JPEG, which are bitmap formats. Most vector images must be converted into bitmap images or rasterized before they can be used on the web, which is quite an easy thing to do in Adobe Illustrator anyway. As mentioned in the previous section, a vector format allows for a crisp and clean design that retains quality at any scale. This is why Adobe Illustrator is so useful for logo designs. When a business comes to designing or redesigning their logo and brand identity, they will probably use the logo on small areas such as letterheads and business cards, but also all the way up to huge proportions on billboards and posters. To ensure the artwork of the logo maintains a crisp and sharp look throughout, the original design must be a vector format. Those mathematical points that Adobe Illustrator uses, as opposed to pixels, will give you security as a designer that the design will hold quality. It is common knowledge among the professional designers that logo designs should always be vector. As we know, Adobe Illustrator uses mathematical points and equations to generate design. Along these points, you will create paths that make up the design. This is the fundamental fabric of Illustrator, and you will see just how much you can do with Illustrator path operations. In the Pathfinder window, for example, you can merge, join, subtract, and go crazy with shapes. This is handy in logo designing as just one example. Using the Live Trace tool, you can upload any image to Illustrator and trace around it with the paths. Now the image will be a vector, allowing you to resize it to any scale whilst retaining quality. Paths are crucial when it comes to vector art design. Digital artists and graphic designers create amazing pieces of artwork using paths in Adobe Illustrator. And as we have said countless times in this video, the artwork will be vectorized, ensuring that the artist can export it to any size without it being pixelated. Also, Illustrator can turn any text into a path too. This is an amazingly handy tool for designers, because then that allows you to edit text and any typeface point by point. So you can see why Adobe Illustrator and its path operations are so useful for graphic design. If you use Adobe Photoshop, you will be aware of the stroke tool. Well, Adobe Illustrator has one too. However, it is on a whole nother level. You can stroke shapes and text, which is pretty normal. But if you utilize the offset path and multiple stroke options, you can make some very interesting and cool looking stroke designs. I actually have an entire video based around the stroke techniques in Illustrator if you want to check it out. Creating strokes in this way is amazing for hand lettering logos, for example, and you can get really creative with it. So to conclude, the main reason why Adobe Illustrator is essential for graphic design is the fact that it uses a vector-based program. This would ensure that your graphics and artwork retain their sharp, crisp quality when resized to any scale. The paths and points used in Illustrator are so easy to use and amazingly effective not only for graphic designers, but artists alike. There are many other reasons why Illustrator is a great tool, but here are my top 4 reasons for graphic design. I hope you enjoyed my video on why Adobe Illustrator is a great tool for graphic design. If you found it helpful, smash that like button and leave a comment below. If you really enjoyed it, share it to someone else and subscribe to stay updated. Until next time, design your future today. Peace.